everyone. Welcome to Grace Hollow Rabbitry. I'm PJ. And before we get started, what I'm going to do is some health checks. I've had, as you all know, some health issues this year. And as it turns out, the artery in my neck has blocked 100% blood flow to my brain out of that artery. You have four, and one of mine don't work, and they can't fix it. You know, even though I'm doing very well, I'm better off now than I have been in, you know, several years. I'm doing quite well, and I don't anticipate, you know, any changes in that. I'll only expect to get better and better with each passing day. But the fact of the matter is, I am still high risk for, you know, another stroke at any point because of that artery being damaged. So with that being said, you know, my rabbits was a tremendous burden when I was unable to get out here and take care of them myself. You know, it was left up to Daddy Jay and my kids to do so. And, you know, the rabbits is my project, you know. No one knows how to take care of them the way I do. They fed them, they watered them, they, you know, got them. They all survived. No damage done there, but you know, John works 6 days a week, many times, often 12 hours every day, and then you know, he had to come home, take care of me, take care of the goats, the chickens, and 100 rabbits or so. You know, that was a really big burden on him. Now, you know, if that ever happens again, I just, well, to make a long story short, I'm selling a bunch of my rabbits. I'm still going to keep the blues and broken blues. Excuse me. But for now, I think to get my numbers down and have a more manageable number in case it falls upon Daddy Jay or someone else again, or at least until I'm in a position that I can hire help or something. I just want to make things as easy for my family as I can. So I will be selling a whole bunch of my rabbits, and but I will be continuing with the blues. So anyway, now that I've given you that little news flash, I have sold my entire New Zealand Red herd. They're all going to a friend of mine, someone who I know takes very good care of the rabbits, and I'm glad they're all going together. They don't have to be broke up, so that really pleases me. So they are actually leaving tomorrow, and so I need to get my paperwork ready for them. And what I want to do is bring them all out one at a time and give them a good thorough check over to make sure, you know, everything is good with them, and get some current weights and things of that nature so it can be on the pedigrees. And so, a bittersweet thing. I'm glad they're all going together. I'm glad they're going to have a fantastic home. But I'm going to miss them tremendously. It's just something I feel I must do. So let's go ahead and get started on the health
check. Hey, girl, how are you?
Huh?
Let me get the scales, huh?
I tell you what, I carried you over here, and I don't think you maintained your weight. If you remember, this is Cincinnati, by the way. And if you remember, she was overweight, and I had to put her on a diet to get her bread. And so she's got, you know, her five babies. And she's been a marvelous mom. She's just done beautiful with them. And I think she's gained her weight back. And I'm guessing she'll have to go back on a diet again before she can be bred. But, you know, I can't control how much food she's eating because she has babies, and the babies have to eat. So I think this girl's going to have to go on a diet. But she looks remarkably well to have a litter on her. She is certainly not hungry. She's looking real good. All right, I want to check her teat, make sure you know, she's doing okay. She's doing wonderful. Looks real good. Now let's get a weight. Oh, good grief. She is a ton, man. Look at that. Holy crap. You're not going to believe this. You remember she was, what, 12 pounds, 8 ounces? And I put her on a diet, and I got her down to 11 pounds, 14 ounces, and then bred her. She's still nursing her babies. I mean, they're, I don't know, probably around 8-9 weeks old. But she's still nursing. This girl is 13 pounds, 6 ounces. I mean, she's huge. Definitely, she's going to have to go on a diet before she can be rebred, because she's going to have a hard time conceiving. Oh, good grief, she's a ton. Oh, man, I'm going to be sad to see you go. What a beautiful girl. Okay, I'm going to trim her toenails, and then she'll be ready for her new home. So now we have Fate. And I tell you what, this is a big girl, but she's nowhere near as big as Cincinnati was. She's raised 3 of Madison babies. And then she still has her 2. And you can tell she's been nursed down just a little bit. But she's still quite big. And I'm looking at her. She has gotten stung on the tip of her nose. Her nose is swelled up. Look at this. Look at her nose. Can you see her nose? She's been stung. All right, let's take a look. She's got a little bit of a bite here. She looks good, other than she, one of her teats had been bitten. And she's ready to be bred, but I would treat that teat and treat that nose. Let the nose heal up before I treat her or breed her. I would wait. All right, let's trim some toenails. Oh, let's see what you're weighing. She's lost a little weight, but she's still a big girl. 11 pounds, 14 ounces. So Actually, she's gained weight. I'm surprised because she actually feels like she needs to be fed a little bit. She's a little, she's been nursed, you know. That's what happens when does nurse a litter. All right, then we have Hoxie, and boy, boy, next to those other two girls, she's a lightweight. But she's always been a little small. She's usually about 9'14", so let's see what she is today. 9 pounds 12. That's pretty accurate for her. Let's see. 9 pounds 12 ounces. But now Mars, you know, Mars is to breed her with. And he's a big buck. But this girl, she sure is a nice doe. And just on the small side. But that's why we have a big buck for her. All right, let's look you over, young lady. Of course, it's summertime. And everyone is losing their fur. Look at that. Look at that. Just blowing that coat. Looking awful. In my pocket.
Gonna have to have those.
Yes. I have a camera rolling. Here you go.
Right in the water. Good going.
All right. Yours look good. No, she hasn't been bred. I didn't breed her during the summer. And so she's not had any babies in a while. She had a couple litters in the spring, though. So she's good and ready to go. She's ready to breed at any time. A nice big old Mars would be nice for her.
Oh,
let's get you flipped over. There we go. There. Looking good, girl. Let's trim your toenails. Got a horsefly flying around my head. There you go. All right, and the last doe. Here's Memphis. She's nursing a litter. And she's nursed down. She's lost weight. She is 9 pounds, 10 ounces. And she's normally about 10.5 pounds, so she's lost weight. But she's raising a litter of 8, so, you know, that's normal. Well, she's got a case of ear mites here. I'm going to have to treat that. Got your mites in one of her ears, so we'll treat that before she goes, and I'll call the buyer and make sure she still wants her. Oh, and she wants to be bred. What were you? 9, 10, right? Okay. Let's trim your toenails. Alright, so here's our first buck. This is Mars, the senior buck. Man, he's such a nice buck. Gonna miss you. Let's see what you are, Mars. He's a big buck. 10.5 pounds. All right, let's take a look at you, big guy. Huh? Take a look at you, big guy. Yeah. All right, let's flip you over, huh? We already looked at the top side. Now, guys, I want to emphasize, when you see me do this, look at that. I can let go. I hold the ears for stability. Never, please, never pick up a rabbit by their ears. Hold them by the head. Rest their head in your hand, and then put your fingers between their ears, and you can hold their ears for support. But don't put weight on those ears, okay? That's just cruel. Don't do that to your bunny. Alright, yeah, you looking good. Alright, let's trim your toenails. Huh? Well, you haven't missed any meals, have you, boy? Huh? I think you missed the toenail trimming at one point, though. You got some claws there, buddy. All right, and here's our little junior buck. And he's out of Nebo and Ozark. So he is a little small. But man, look at the body on this guy. I mean, he is just such a beautiful buck. And some beautiful, beautiful color. Although I do think he might end up being a little small. But you never know, they might catch up after... You know, sometimes they do. Let's see. Now, 7 pounds, 4 ounces. And I think he's, I'm not sure. I think he's probably a March baby. So I'm thinking he's like 5 months. He may even be approaching, I don't know, maybe he's an April 1st baby. I know I had some red babies on April 1st. Here, I can tell you. Oh, okay, so he's older than I thought. He was actually born... Oh, I was thinking 1st of March, and he was born February 28th. So, he is... He's 6 months. He's a little older than I thought. So, yeah, he's going to be small, but he could still catch up, but I think he's going to be small, and that's okay, because he's got some 12 and 13 pound does that he can breed, and look at that power punch that he has. I mean, he's a fabulous buck. He's just small. We'll touch his toenails real quick. All right. So, everyone looks pretty good. We had Memphis... that I'll treat for ear mites. And then we had Fate, who had a nipple, a teat bitten. And so I'll put some cream on that. But you know, that's nothing. It's already healing up. So it's just a precaution. But anyway, everyone looks pretty good. So I'm going to call their new owners and let them know how they're doing. So, there we have it. There's our health checks. Everyone's doing real good. And sadly, the next rabbit video I do, these guys will all be gone. They're leaving tomorrow after work. But I'm excited about who's getting them. I'm really pleased about that. So, hey, thanks for watching, and until we speak again, God bless.